Meltdowns have been going on for days now, a little over a week. And back here in Chicago, people are showing solidarity with those protesters.
And tonight we're hearing from the Puerto Rican Agenda. They're hosting a watch party as we speak. WGN's Sean Lewis is live from the Northwest side with the latest for us. Sean?
Hey there, guys. There's always a tipping point in any political movement. This one in Puerto Rico came in a 21st century way in the form of leaked emails and text messages by the governor and a whole host of political higher-ups in Puerto Rico. It led to those massive protests and a call on the governor to resign.
In San Juan, another night of protests calling for a change at the top of Puerto Rico's government.
Ricky, renuncia!
The call echoed in Chicago and other communities as well. Ricky, renuncia. Ricky, resign. Hundreds of thousands wanting Governor Ricardo Rossello to step down. Years of alleged mismanagement and sweetheart deals for the connected boiled over when 889 pages of text between the governor, his officials, and aides from last year became public.
You know, the fact that he participated in something like that, I mean, I really believe that the people in Puerto Rico have just had enough.
Illinois State Senator Iris Martinez is one of those in Chicago supporting the moves against the governor. The group text of all men made sexist and homophobic jokes, joked about shooting San Juan's female mayor, and made light of Hurricane Maria victims, among other transgressions. Singer Ricky Martin, the target of one of the anti-gay jokes, is now vocal online, calling on Puerto Rico's legislature to impeach the governor. On Sunday, Rossello apologized again and said he would not seek re-election but would not resign.
It's even worse. It made it worse by saying that.
Leading some in Chicago's Puerto Rican community who differ politically to come together on this issue.
What this has done is that it has, you know, taken the lid off the entire political system really in Puerto Rico.
It's also thrown that system into limbo. The scandal prompted the resignation of several officials, including Rossello's chief financial officer and secretary of state, who's the first in line of succession to the governorship. For those meeting in Chicago tonight to watch the San Juan protests,
it's less important what happens immediately afterwards. It's more important to really know the capability of the people of Puerto Rico, the capacity that they have to create change.
That watch party, hosted in part by the Puerto Rican Agenda, starts at 6 o'clock tonight at 4048 West Armitage. As far as the president is concerned, he is also chiming in about these protests and what he thinks of the Puerto Rican governor. That is coming up new at 6. For now, we are live in Hermosa. Sean Lewis, WGN News.